This is the cover of Life magazine from 12th of December 1969. Inside is an article about the Apollo 12 lunar landing mission, which had returned to Earth a couple of weeks previously. There are some nice photos of Pete Conrad and Alan Bean going about their tasks on the lunar surface. But what's this? On page 37. A photograph of the Surveyor 3 unmanned lander. How can that be? Genius expat Taffy reckons the Surveyor craft couldn't have existed before 1973. What is going on? Surveyor 3 landed on the moon in April 1967. So where does Taffy get the laughable idea that the vehicle itself could not have physically existed until 1973? According to Taffy, Surveyor was fastened together using pop rivets, which, apparently, weren't invented until years after Surveyor landed on the moon. Let's see. Wikipedia states that the pop rivet was invented in 1916. But we won't be relying just on Wikipedia. Let's see what else we can find. You can see adverts for pop rivets in magazines and trade publications from the 1940s and 1950s. And visit eBay and other such consumer-to-consumer websites to have a look at the hardware itself from the period. The photos brought back by the Apollo 12 astronauts in 1969 were not the first time the public had seen the Surveyor series of unmanned spacecraft. They were already well acquainted with it. For example, the first Surveyor lunar landing was featured in the October 1966 issue of National Geographic magazine. And there she is, an object which Taffy claims was still years away. And let's finish with a newsreel from 1967.
At the Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena, workers watch a living milestone in America's space exploration. Surveyor 3 is about to touch down on the lunar surface, the best landing ever. On target, the first photo shows its own antenna. A model of the three-legged moon robot demonstrates equipment used to probe lunar land. It's a surface sampler which scrapes, digs, and drills. Tests of the space shovel proved its ability to dig 2 feet into the ground. It also cracked 1-inch thick concrete. Powered by 4 motors, it can probe an area 24 feet square. The real moonship sent back pictures of soil samples, proving the moon surface is firm enough to support great weights. Well done, Surveyor.